Before you change your mind.
Hi there. My name is Fernando Machado, and I am the global CMO for Restaurant Brands International. We have three brands here at Restaurant Brands International. We have Burger King, which is the largest brand we have, and we have Popeyes and Tim Hortons. Tim Hortons is a very strong brand in Canada. It's a coffee baked goods brand in Canada, also present in the US and internationally, but it's a powerhouse in Canada. So today I'm here to talk a little bit about how we are making our brands future-proof. When I think about the biggest challenges, I think that that CMOs have today, one of them is to find the right balance between short-term and long-term. We talk a lot short-term on the day-to-day. I think that everyone in organization needs to be driving short-term results. That's basic, right? I mean, I don't think a CMO would survive 12, 18 months on the job if the results are not there. So short-term is definitely something important. But we also need to think about the things that we should be doing today so that our brands are still relevant 5, 10 years from now. You know, like building short-term sales is our duty, but building the brand for the long-term is our legacy. So here at Restaurant Brands International, we created a framework for that. Right. I mean, when I think about the vision that we have as a company, which we call like the big dream, our big dream is to have the most loved brands in the restaurant industry in the world. So if you want to have the most loved brands, you cannot be just doing the short term. You know, like we need to be investing for these brands to be strong in the future. In the framework that we created, to help us organize ourselves and to focus on the right things is called Restaurant Brands for Good. And the meaning behind Restaurant Brands for Good comes from the belief that the delicious, affordable, and convenient meals that you love should also be sustainable. So we have three pillars on our Restaurant Brands for Good framework. One pillar has to do with the food. Right, I mean, all the work that we do to improve food quality, and we'll talk a little bit about that. Then the second pillar has to do with environmental sustainability, which is like the planet. And the third pillar has to do with people and communities. I'm not going to talk a lot about the third pillar today. I'll be focusing more on the food and planet pillars. On the people and communities pillar, we do all our work around diversity and inclusion, the work around the foundations that each of our brands have. We have foundations that provide support to people and communities, all the work that you do around our crew and our people internally. It's not the main point on the presentation, but if you want to know more, you can go to our website, rbi.com/sustainability, and there'll be a lot of information there. So in terms of food and planet, so let me talk first about the food pillar. Food is what we sell. So we are constantly investing to improve the quality of our food. It's not always easy to do that, you know what I mean? Like, especially when it comes to serving real ingredients. If you think about fast food, people who come to eat at Burger King, we do have salads, we do have grilled chicken, we have all that. But normally when people come, they're looking for a more indulgent type of meal. But even if it's indulgent, they want something that's real. You know, they don't want something that's loaded with artificial ingredients or that has a lot of MSG or that has high fructose corn syrup. Like, people are looking for real food. So for the past, I would say, 5-6 years, we've been on a journey to clean up our food. And when I say clean up, it's basically like removing colors, flavors, and preservatives from artificial sources, removing MSG, removing high-fructose corn syrup, removing anything that detracts from realness. And we've been doing that globally. Yeah, here in the U.S., our portfolio is around today 85% clean. That's how we say. And soon enough, we'll have 100% clean. We launched this year a Whopper that is 100% clean. So no fillers, no preservatives from artificial sources, no colors or flavors from artificial sources, no MSG, no heptones considered. It's the real thing. And it's not easy to do that. You know, there are cost implications to doing that. Sometimes when you change one ingredient, there is an impact on taste. It becomes more difficult in terms of the logistics, supply chain, and operations. Like the shelf life diminishes, like you have to refrigerate some stuff that before you could just keep at room temperature. What's the important thing to do? And because we are Burger King, right? I mean, because we first did that with Burger King, we're also doing Popeyes and Tim Hortons. But when we announced the Whopper, we really wanted to create an impact out there and make people notice what we're doing so we can capitalize on that. So we came up with a groundbreaking campaign that was called Moji Whopper, and I will play the case study for you so that you can take a look at that.
Fast food, an industry that offers convenient, craveable food at a good value. But
You put out a back and you could keep it there forever, right?
It's right here.
No fungus, no mold, no smell.
Why is there no mold on that?
Well, because of all the stuff we put in our food.
What we put in our bodies.
It's time to change that.
What a difference a day made.
Burger King is rethinking the image of its signature Whopper burger.
They're turning a lot of heads with a new ad. Maybe some stomachs too.
Showing that mold can be a beautiful thing.
It shows a moldy Whopper as a way to announce that the fast food chain will no longer put preservatives in their food.
The beauty
of no artificial preservatives.
I think it's great. It's very risky, but I think it's a really neat commercial.
It's fascinating and gross at the same time. When I watch this, I'm like, I can't unsee this, but also I can't stop watching it.
When one company makes a decision like this, it certainly have ripples effects across the whole industry.
So is this really the best way to sell a burger?
Well, I know the difference in you.
Look, they're taking out preservatives. This is the real deal.
I think it really speaks to the fact that companies are hearing this huge tectonic shift of customers asking real questions about what's in their food.
They're removing preservatives because they feel real food tastes better.
The difference is you.
So really cool campaign, shocking, but like that's what we need as a brand, you know, like to shake people out of their comfort zone and show them some of the amazing things we're doing. So this, I think, is a great example of like how to improve food quality. We've been doing more things. Like we became global leaders in plant-based burgers. In the U.S., we have a partnership with Impossible Foods. And for the past year and a half, we have been offering like the Impossible Whopper in our restaurants. That has been a huge success. We also have a partnership with Unilever in Europe on plant-based burgers. We have partnerships with different suppliers across the globe on plant-based burgers. We have plant-based burgers in more than 35 countries at the moment, and they will continue to grow. But I don't have time to talk about that. So I'll flip to the next pillar, which is the planet pillar. So in terms of planet, we do a lot of work making our packaging more environmentally friendly, making our restaurants more environmentally friendly, not just the materials, but also the processes inside of the restaurant. We do a lot of work in terms of traceability of ingredients, in terms of like asking our suppliers to do the right thing and making them commit to that. There are many examples that I could showcase here. I hope I have time to show two examples for you. One is Project Meltdown. Project Meltdown is part of our commitment to remove all non-biodegradable plastic toys from our system by 2025. And believe me, we do have a lot of plastic toys in our system. It's funny that in terms of number of toys, we are probably like the number two toy manufacturer, not manufacturer because like we sell, but we are number two in the world in terms of toys. So the volumes that you command are very, very high. And I have a 5-year-old and I also have a 9-month-old, but like my 5-year-old, when he gets one of those plastic toys, he's very excited about it for like 2 minutes and then he throws it away, you know? And that becomes single-use plastic. So we committed to ban non-biodegradable plastic toys by 2025, but we already started to remove them now. The UK is one of our most important markets globally. It's a market that has a strong component of party with kids, which is where the kids' meal belongs. And on UK, we already remove all plastic, non-biodegradable plastic toys, and that was part of Project Meltdown. I'll show a very short video to you.
Wait, did that just say?
So that was Project Meltdown. Another good example that that I'd like to share is a project that we call it Cow's Menu. We noticed that there were some scientists working on developing like a natural feed additive to add to the diet of cattle to help reduce methane emissions. If you're not aware of that, cattle tends to produce a considerable amount of methane emissions during the digestion, and the burps of the cow, the cattle, I know it sounds funny, but the burps, it's mostly burps, but a little bit of fart, but mostly burps produce methane, and that's not good for the environment. So we partnered with a group of scientists in Mexico first that was developing and working on this, and we evaluated different types of additives, all natural. After doing a lot of research, we found that adding 100 grams of lemongrass to the cattle diet can reduce on up to 33% the methane emissions. We are doing more research around that. We also partnered with UC Davis here in the U.S. We have a partnership with a university in Europe. We are replicating the tests in Brazil because cattle can be different and the feed can be different to make sure that we can expand that and continue to work with our partners and farmers who also have other ways to reduce methane. There is a lot of work going on this area. So this is one of those projects that we are like on the leading edge, like a, really like a scientific development. We published a paper, which was peer-reviewed around the topic. So I'll just show a little bit of the, I don't have time to show entirely, but if you go on YouTube and search Cow's Menu, Burger King, you'll see this. But I'll show a little bit of the clip that we created to make this consumer facing to people.
When cows fart and burp and splatter, well, it ain't no laughing matter. They're releasing methane every time they do. And that methane from the rear goes up through the atmosphere and pollutes our planet warming me and you.
So just to wrap it up, I think that if I were to leave you with one message, my message would be that as a marketeer or as like a leadership on your company, you always need to be thinking about the short term and the long term. And when it comes to long-term, I think it's very hard to argue that investing on improving product quality, whatever product you have, and investing behind environmental sustainability will help you guarantee a better future for your brand and for your company. In our case, we created a framework for that. And I think that helps because tackling these things can become really complex and you end up like losing sight or what's priority, and having a framework can really help you on that. And then do the work first. I always say action, not ads. You know, like I think that we all have to do the work first, and then we can capitalize potentially on this work by communicating. But it's really important that you do the work, improve the quality of our products, whatever that means to your category and to your brand, improve your environmental footprint, and hopefully also make sure that your brand and your company are doing good for people and communities. I haven't touched a lot on that, but that's also one of the pillars of our Restaurant Brands for Good framework. I hope this helped you on your journey. I'm always on Twitter, so feel free to reach out. Find me there, ask me questions. I'm always happy to engage. Thanks for having me. Bye-bye.